Most prisoners will be released, making it everyone's concern they learn and get job skills. Thousands of inmates are reportedly missing out, as Missouri's staffing crisis is putting more offenders in lockdown.
Ultimately, the system's going to break. We've had four good wake-up calls.
Bill Schmutz is former deputy warden at Algoa in Jefferson City. He points to the maximum security prison Crossroads as one of those wake-up calls, with its 1,500 prisoners, a summer riot, and an unprecedented 100-day lockdown.
The staff are overworked, stressed out. They start cutting corners.
He says staff shortages are forcing prisons into lockdowns to keep everyone safe. That means shutting down movement to education and job training for inmates who will be your neighbor. Brandy Stockton's son is one of them.
He went to prison at the age of 19. He is set for immediate release in exactly 23 months. So he's going to come home. He's going to come home uneducated, with no training, no rehabilitation.
Stockton testified at a public meeting in Jefferson City.
You either close the facility immediately, in my opinion, or you staff it at a level that's safe for everybody that lives there, for everybody that works there.
I don't see one person in here works for the Department of Corrections.
Representative Brandon Ellington arranged this meeting after the Department of Corrections illegally denied him access.
You are not going to be allowed to be on site until you meet with the director.
He wanted to check on prisoners at Crossroads who stopped getting services. He documented his trip to the prison with his cell phone.
What are you covering up?
Bishop Tony Caldwell said Missouri is setting itself up for higher crime.
To be treated like animals and then released back out on the streets, and we wonder why our cities are the way that they are.
Tuesday night at 10, hear what it's like for a 27-year-old inside the crumbling corrections system, what you're paying for, and how you could pay the price as prisoners are released daily. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.